Hi and welcome. In this tutorial, I will teach you how to create super neat text effects by using the Text Animator asset and TextMeshPro. I am a huge fan of using great tools to simplify my workflows, and Text Animator is one such tool I wouldn't want to miss anymore. Be aware, it's a paid asset and you will find an affiliate link to the asset store in the video's description, but this is not sponsored. I am absolutely positive. If you are working with texts in your games, you will gain so much value from it. And that's not just me. There's quite a couple games you might know about who do as well. Alright, what are we going to have a look at here? First, we'll create a typewriter effect and have a look at customizability, events on when we want stuff to happen, and adding sounds. Next are so-called behavior events. They change how your text is being displayed. There are many customization settings, we will have a look at a few. Afterwards, a very short introduction to the fact that Text Animator lets you create your own tags, which is something I wished for so hard for TextMeshPro. And lastly, we'll have a short look at the honestly amazing documentation and my great customer support experience. Alright, let's start with a typical use case, a dialogue box. Just displaying text is kinda boring, honestly, and most games use some kind of typewriter effect to mimic the time it takes to speak. First step after installing Text Animator is to attach the Text Animator component, of course. To get a typewriter effect, activate the checkmark behind Use Easy Integration. The tooltip tells us to add a Text Animator player, so we'll do that. Let's have a look at the result. Well, that's a solid base. Let's have a look at the settings. We can have the typewriter start from different scenarios. Currently, it will start as soon as the object is being enabled. We can set this to other modes too, of course. The typewriter effect can also be skipped. In this case, the effect gets sped up considerably. You can change that by activating the next toggle, in which case it will just be displayed all at once. We'll have a look at events in a moment. They are awesome. The probably most important setting here is the typewriter weight. You can fine-tune how fast or slow you want the letters to appear. The avoid multiple punctuation weight handles scenarios when you might use ellipses or multiple interpunctuation. The base effect, which scales the letters, is neat, but let's see what else we can do. On your Text Animator, you see a list of effects lists. One for fallbacks and one to edit. Open the Edit Appearances and Disappearances and next Built-in Appearances Disappearances. The typewriter effect falls into this category since it makes the letters appear. Next, open Size. You'll see a duration and an amplitude. Change the value of the amplitude to change the effect's strength. An amplitude of 1 means your appearing letters won't be changing any size. I think a value of 1.5 works great here. It doesn't distract too much while still being noticeable. In the documentation, you'll find a couple more styles too. You can set these effects either by code or as the default ways to have your texts appear or disappear. For the letter way, open Default Appearances and change the name of the effect you'd like to have. This is a list, so you can absolutely mix and match as you like. It works the same for the disappearances, of course. But if you enjoy it, you can have different effects for both things. So appearance is, for example, fade and size, and disappearance could be size and random direction, for example. You can also set appearances and disappearances by code, and there are also tags to change the waiting times between typing, for example, if you want to give certain words more emphasis. Events are amazingly useful and I love how they are implemented. Let's say I want my guinea pig to look happy once they talk about food, and a second time when both agree on going on an adventure together. I won't be using the Unity events here, but instead use a small extra system for it to have more control. That's my change sprites on event script. It looks like this. I need to hand it the images for my two guinea pigs, one for the normal head and one for the happy one. Down here, I define what I want to happen on certain keywords. These keywords get used like this inside the strings I want to display. Don't forget the question mark, it prefaces the event we want to happen. Let's see how my scene looks now. This ability alone made me want to get this asset, honestly. It's super useful and brings so much life to your dialogue. Lastly, on the topic of typewriter effects, you might have wished at some point to have your characters do vocalizations while speaking. You can either write your own implementation and make it super specific to your needs, or use the example soundwriter packaged into Text Animator. To find it, navigate to your plugins folder, Febucci, Text Animator Extra. Double-click on the file and accept. Add the included component called Soundwriter to your TMP game object. You'll need an audio source for it to work, so for this tutorial, right-click in your hierarchy, Audio, Audio Source. You don't need to change anything. Drop in the amount of sounds you want the assets to use, and you're already done. Onwards to behavior effects. They change how your text is being displayed, and again, you'll have a good amount of base options available. Every effect has a so-called tag and a few modifiers. If you've seen my tutorial on using TextMeshPro tags, you already know I love these, so let's give them a try. You just write them onto your string at the part you want to be affected. Don't forget to close the tag. You can edit the behaviors of these effects easily. I'll stay in play mode for this. Go to Edit Behaviors, Built-in Behaviors, and navigate to your chosen effect. I'll increase the frequency of bounds, and as you can see, it already feels much more hectic. The amplitude correlates to the effect's strength. Just make sure your text stays readable when tinkering with this. Wave size is dependent on how much text is inside the tags. A wave size of 1 means the effect will be displayed all at once on your tagged text. A wave size of 0.5 has the effect work on alternating letters, for example. Some effects, like shake, can also have a delay value. It's basically an effects per second value, at least that's how I made myself remember its use. Take note of the small modifier letters. You can use these to set the effects you want by code like this. And of course, you can also combine these text effects with one another to your heart's content. Text Animator lets you create your own text. I repeat, create your own tags with effects, movements, events, whatever you can think of. That's the one thing I wanted so dearly from TextMeshPro, and finally it's possible. This is probably the most complex system I encountered within Text Animator, just because it gives us so many possibilities, so I can only scratch the surface here. There are two ways to create tags, in the editor and by script. I'll show you both with an example. First comes the editor version. Create a new folder and call it Resources. Inside, right-click, Create, Text Animator, Text Animator Global Data. A new scriptable object will be created. You can create behaviors, appearances, and actions, like the weight we saw in the beginning here. I want to create a behavior, so open that one up and click Add New Behavior Effect. Open this one up and give it a name to use as a tag. You'll have a couple of useful options here, and it's a lot of fun experimenting with the possibilities. I limit myself to color for now. With these animation curves, by the way, you handle the way your type moves, for example. With the character's time offset, the effect will be distributed along the letters. I'll quickly create a gradient like this and give it some offset to mimic the rainbow effect. The tag can obviously be used like any other. You see, this was super quick. Let's have a look at how to get the same effect by writing it via code. I really enjoy the rainbow effect, but a complete rainbow might be a bit too much for some instances. There is a base version of the code you'll need on the documentation. I copied that, added the tag I want to use, in this case I'll call it magic, and because I like the rainbow effect so much, I actually copied most of the code too. I won't show all of it here, since I'm not sure if that's okay with the creator, but if you have the asset, you can look at every basic behavior and see how it works. They are great starting points. In the function that handles the color change, I create a new gradient by script and have it animate the color picked from the gradient based on the time and behavior values like this. Lastly, the color gets set to the character data. This is how the result looks. Oh, and of course you can have it affect sprites too. Before I come to a quick tip about animated sprites in Text Animator, a short review about the documentation and customer support. In short, Text Animator has the hands-down best documentation I have ever seen for an asset from the asset store, and I've got a few. Well, when I got into how this asset worked and needed to look up things either for my own projects or this tutorial, I never felt lost or confused or didn't know where I would find answers. It is well structured and I love that Febucci also included images wherever they make sense. It makes understanding so much easier. When you install the asset, there are a couple demo scenes included, which all revolve around different things you can do with Text Animator. They are well made too, and offer a great tutorial on how to get started. They are all built in an easy to understand way, with no distractions. I had to contact customer support once due to a bug about using animated sprites with appearance or disappearance effects. I think I had to wait about a day or two to get a very friendly and helpful answer to my problem, including a script that would fix my problem. In my book, that's quick, especially since I seem to have been the only person to ever contact support with this issue. I am absolutely happy with this asset in quite frankly every regard. Alright, about that quick fix for animated sprites. Thing is, if you're using the typewriter effects, your animated sprites will flicker a bit during the appearing and disappearing moments. You can fix it by setting update mode to manual and creating a new script with these contents. Basically, you'll need to set the update to late update like you can see here. Attach the script to your game object and the flickering's gone now. Awesome! And a few tiny things I wasn't able to cover anywhere else in this tutorial. You can add the behaviors to sprites, static ones as well as animated ones. This way you can give them gradient effects or even animate them to some extent like here. Absolutely give materials a try when using Text Animator. In the right scenario, it can look super awesome. Alright, let's wrap this monster of a video up. Seriously. This asset has great support and the best asset documentation I ever came across on top of the things it enables you to do in a super easy way. I highly recommend adding it to your toolbox if you're working with text on your games that need a bit more life in them. Again, you'll find the link to the store page in the video's description or in my first comment. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial and overview. It's been a blast to create. Please give the video a like if you did. I'll keep producing design-related videos, so if that's a topic you love, please subscribe. It would make my day. I'm looking forward to seeing you in the next videos. Have a great day!